Good morning, motherfuckers. It's been a while. It's Thursday. What is today? The 22nd of February already? God damn. Shit. One more week of fucking February, guys, and it's March. But Eagles still won the Super Bowl. We're champions. Philadelphia. I hope you're still celebrating because I am. And that's why there have been no videos until now. So let's talk off season. Let's get into it. Let's do it. A lot of shit been going down. I haven't really uploaded a video because I like for everybody to do their speculations and their wrong predictions and their hot takes. And then I like to just spell all the bullshit with some factual statements. Just some good information and debate. So, main headline is, are we going to trade Nick Foles? Now, y'all are aware that Carson Wentz tore his ACL, right? Now, I know we got Nate Sudfeld, and, you know, he looked like Nick Foles, honestly. Like, he looked like he's going to be the Nick Foles of the future. But, I'm not trading Nick Foles. For one, he's only signed for 2 years. So, he's only got 1 year left on his contract, which means any team that signs Nick Foles is going to want to do a contract extension. What exactly are they trading to do a contract extension with Nick Foles? Like, who is going to trade for Nick Foles and have him start as their quarterback? Their guy. He is the guy. Now, Nick Foles had an amazing run, y'all. Like, we just needed him to win those 3 games for us in the playoffs, and he did it. He played excellent. But Nick Foles is a system QB. Carson Wentz is not. Nick Foles is a system QB, which means Nick Foles needs to have the right weapons, the right coaching, the right situations for him to succeed. So, when you want to say that Carson Wentz is a system QB, that's incorrect because Carson Wentz made everybody around him better. Nick Foles just managed the game. I mean, it's not like he was making everyone better. Nelson Aguilar was having a breakout year before Nick Foles came along. You feel me? Carson Wentz, he had almost, 4,000 yards last year with no wide receivers. Like, it's Nick Foles is a good guy. Good QB. I'm so fucking happy he got a ring. He deserved it. He's been through a lot of shit in his career. But I don't think Nick Foles is a franchise quarterback. However, for one more year, Carson is still injured. We do not know who's going to start the season or if he will start the season. You need Nick Foles and you need Nate Sudfeld as his backup to start the season. And then you can trade Nick Foles during the season if somebody needs a quarterback. You feel me? Because there will be desperate teams who will give up third and second round picks for Nick Foles next season. Because you never know what happens with these young quarterbacks, these old quarterbacks. Like, you just don't know what's going to happen. He could be a bridge quarterback until, you know, their young one is ready. Who knows? But I'm not trading Nick Foles. Now, we have no cap space, basically, but a lot of guys who are coming back or are going into free agency or we need to sign and do an extension. Now, Vinny Curry is gone. I like Vinny Curry. He's been a good player for us. However, Derek Barnett has the talent and the opportunity to be great, and that is just something Curry is not. And so when I think about that $9 million in cap space he's taking up, oh, he's got to be traded. He's got to go. And I know somebody's gonna want him. Somebody will. I don't know who out here talking some bullshit, talking about trading our cornerbacks, but shut the fuck up. We haven't had cornerbacks in a long time. Why would you want to trade them when we just get them? The fuck? Y'all need to go back to when we had Nnamdi Asamoah and we had fucking Leotis McKelvin and Nolan Carroll. Like, do y'all fucking remember? Go back. Just go back and shut the fuck up. We have a lot of young, beautiful cornerback talent, and Sidney Jones has come back healthy, y'all. He is going to be our number one corner. Yes, Darby is there, but Sidney Jones is going to be better than Darby, I'm telling you. Trey Burton, I love Trey Burton. He is like, he's everything in this offense. He can do everything. But I don't know if we'll have the money to retain him. Trey Burton has, like, he can be a Pro Bowl tight end. I don't really, people are saying, oh, he's just a backup. But he had, like, 70 yards and 2 touchdowns the first game Zach Ertz was out. Like, that's not just a backup. He's a starter, and he deserves money, and he has a ring. So if he doesn't get it in Philadelphia, I will completely understand if he wants to go somewhere else. I said he should go to Chicago with Mitch Trubisky, and basically, I mean, you would be their fucking guy. You would be the main weapon because they don't really have anybody else right now. Offseason is just starting. They can sign Paul Richardson or something. I don't know. I like to talk about other teams too. But I feel like Billy Brown, I really liked him in the offseason and fucking preseason training camp. He can step up for Trey Burton. Nigel Bradham is the tough one. Now, I want the Eagles to either draft a linebacker or a safety in the first round. Now, it's not like we have to out of necessity, but if they're the best available, why not? Because Jalen Watkins ain't coming back, and he wasn't even that good of a third safety anyway. We need some youth. We need, like, homegrown safeties because we don't have any. Like, y'all, we don't have any. We got Trey Sullivan. He's a hard hitter. So hopefully he can, you know, step up. But we're going to need, unless we move Jalen Mills to safety after Jenkins leaves, we're going to need a safety. And, shit, it could be Mills be the third safety and we get another, and Jones be starting and then we sign another corner or get one in the draft. I don't know. But there's a lot of things we got to do. Jason Peters, he's got to be back, but he's got to take a pay cut. Like, you got your ring, you're getting your last year, now help us out and take less money. I do believe Vaitai will be the starter of the future. Do we have to rush him? No, but he improved drastically in the playoffs. I mean, I don't know if I heard his name called once. Who else we got? Michael Kendricks, man, I love him. Fucking Angry Bird, man. He's been through a lot in this city, and I'm glad he's got a ring. But I don't know if we're going to keep him. If we keep Bradham, we don't keep Kendricks. So I don't know. Howie's got some tough decisions. He did it last year, and we won a Super Bowl. Like, we didn't have no cap last year, but somehow we got Alshon Jeffrey, we got Chris Long, we got LeGarrette Blount, we got Torrey Smith. And Torrey Smith. You know what? I want Torrey Smith back, but at the same time, I want Hollins to get his playing time. Like, I like Torrey Smith, and I would feel bad because he had a pretty good year. I mean, he had a few key drops, but I mean, I still feel like he had 600-700 yards, right? Or something like that. And, or maybe 4 or 5. I don't know. I didn't check his stats this year. But, I feel like Mac Hollins can really develop into something nasty for us, y'all. Like, he's got the downfield speed. He got the fucking Alshon catch radius. Like, that ability to go up and get the ball. He's just got to work on his route running. But 6'4", 220, that's a weapon right there. And we need to give him more playing time. Sheldon Gibson, he needs more playing time. So it's tough for me to say Torrey Smith should be back because he's taken away playing time from our younger guys who need to develop with Carson. So if he can redo his contract, make half of that $5 million he's making, and be a bench player, that could work. But if not, then sayonara, buddy. You got two rings, so Philly loved you. Thanks for having for them. Thanks for having us. Thanks for coming, and good luck. So, a lot of stuff to do this offseason. We're about to get into the nitty gritty in the next couple weeks. I know I said that, but the draft is 2 months away, y'all. Like, I don't know shit about shit right now. I told y'all, I only know a few names. But best believe, by draft time, I'm going to be very versed in these players. And I'm going to be ready. So, for all my haters, I feel bad for y'all because you got nothing else to do. For all Bird Gang, Eagles Nation, I love y'all. Y'all stay true. We're the best fans in the fucking world. Don't let them tell you anything less. Y'all have a good day. Bird Gang out.